The newspaper I found while cleaning the garage gave me an idea to call my university professor. During our conversation, it turned out that he was about to start a new phase of research in exactly the same place as before. However, a lot has changed since then. The quarry has been closed and the underground search for fossils will be conducted at a deeper level than before. Despite the limited budget he had at his disposal, we reached an agreement and I signed the contract. Any problem, I noticed the excavation area in its lowest part. This is where I was to start my search. A few days earlier, a strong wind had destroyed the excavation equipment, so my first job was to clean up the exploration area and set up a new fence. my first professional excavation was an experience that I'll always remember very fondly. Once I took a good look at the fossils I found, I knew I discovered something huge. I told my professor about it right away.
Thank you.
few hours later, he arrived at the excavation site in person and confirmed my assumptions. What I found was part of a dromaeosaur skeleton. It was an important enough discovery for a professor to reach out to media, which were happy to take up the topic. Soon, my discovery had become a countrywide sensation. Thanks to the publicity of the discovery, the town authorities decided to establish a new paleontological museum in the closed sports hall, for which they had been looking for a purpose for some time. The professor was appointed director of the Museum of Paleontology. Even before the facility was opened, I unexpectedly had received an interview invitation from him. Knowing me and seeing my commitment, he decided to offer me a job as a collection manager. I remember being speechless for a moment, but of course, I couldn't refuse. That is how the new stage of the adventure of my life began. I got a longed-for job and a chance to make discoveries that I've been dreaming about since I was a child.